Welcome to MediSimplified. Today we are going to discuss once again a topic from ENT called as malignant otitis externa. After reading the term that is malignant otitis externa, we could have came to a conclusion that it is a malignant pathology. But no, here this name malignant is just a misnomer. That is a false designation is given to the term of malignancy. But it is just an external ear inflammation, that is otitis externa. So before going to the whole term of malignant otitis externa, I'd like to take your attention towards the term otitis externa and its kind. So first we'll talk about otitis externa. What is otitis externa? It is just an inflammation of external auditory canal, of auricle, or of both. It is just an inflammation of the external auditory canal. So there are many kinds of otitis externa. So we'll just discuss some of them in a very brief manner. So they are divided basically into two groups: infective group, and reactive group. The infective group is otitis externa due to any infection, and reactive group is the otitis externa due to any kind of reaction in the body. So we'll start from the infective group. Infective group includes three subtypes, that is bacterial infection, any inflammation due to bacterial infection, any inflammation due to viral infection, or third, any inflammation due to fungal infection. In bacterial infection, we have three. The first is localized otitis externa. I will denote otitis externa with OE in abbreviation. Localized otitis externa. It is most commonly caused due to Staph aureus. The second is diffuse otitis externa. It is also known as, mark my words, it is also known as telephonist's ear, or as Singapore ear. And the third is malignant otitis externa, which is also known as necrotizing otitis externa. Today's topic is malignant otitis externa, which we also call as necrotizing otitis externa. Then we'll talk about the viral infections due to which we can see otitis externa. There are two type of diseases due to viral infection. First is otitis externa hemorrhagica, and the second is herpes zoster otitis. Herpes zoster otitis. And the last, the fungal type of otitis externa is called as otomycosis. The otomycosis is most commonly caused due to Aspergillus niger. Now we'll talk about the reactive group of otitis externa. It includes three diseases, namely first eczematous otitis externa, second seborrheic otitis externa, and third, that is neurodermatitis. So this is the brief introduction of otitis externa. That is, otitis externa is any inflammation of external auditory canal or auricle or both together. They are divided into two groups, infective group and reactive group. Infective group are further divided into bacterial type of otitis externa. Otitis externa due to any bacteria, due to any virus or due to any fungus. Then reactive group, it includes three diseases: eczematous otitis externa, seborrheic otitis externa, and the last, neurodermatitis. In bacterial, we have three: localized otitis externa, which is caused due to staph aureus. Then the second, diffuse otitis externa, which is also called as telephonous ear or Singapore ear. The third, malignant otitis externa, which is also called as necrotizing otitis externa. In viral, we have otitis externa hemorrhagica, herpes zoster oticus. The third, fungal, which is called as otomycosis, and which is caused due to Aspergillus niger. Now we will discuss some questions related to otitis externa, whatever we have discussed till now. So the first question is, diffuse otitis, OE, is also called as. The first option is glue ear, the second is necrotizing otitis externa, the third option is telephonists ear, or the fourth, ASON. Okay, the question is, diffuse otitis externa is also called as. We have four options: glue ear, telephonous ear, necrotizing otitis externa, and ASOM. Glue ear is another name for serous otitis media, so we'll exclude this question, this option. The second option, necrotizing otitis externa, it is another name for malignant otitis externa, so we'll remove this one. Third option is telephonous ear. So the another name for diffuse otitis externa is telephonous ears, or if we may have another option as Singapore's ear. So the correct option is 3, telephonous ear. The second question is, otitis externa hemorrhagica is caused by, which is the causative agent for otitis externa hemorrhagica. The first option is influenza. Second is staphylococcus. Third is streptococcus. And the fourth is Proteus. In the video, we didn't discuss which is the causative agent for otitis externa, but what we know is it is a kind of viral infection due to which we get otitis externa. So we'll exclude in a manner, we'll go from the fourth option. Proteus is a bacteria, so it cannot be the answer. Streptococcus, once again, it is a bacteria, it cannot be the answer. Staphylococcus, once again, it is a bacteria, so it cannot be the answer. So the right answer is influenza. Otitis externa hemorrhagica is most commonly caused by influenza virus. So now the third question. Causes of otomycosis is, first option is candidas. Second is Aspergillus. Third is Staphylococcus. And fourth is Streptococcus. We have already discussed that is the most common causative agent for otomycosis is Aspergillus. Once again, it is a kind of fungal infection. So this can be a correct option, but Staphylococcus and Streptococcus are a bacteria, so we'll exclude them. We already know, we have already discussed, that is the Aspergillus is the most common cause. But what we should know about it, if we don't have Aspergillus in the option, the second most common cause of otomycosis is Candidus. So now out of those various otitis externa, we'll discuss the malignant otitis externa. What is malignant otitis externa? What happens when a patient is having otitis externa? In some cases, it may spread to the surrounding tissues. It may spread to the surrounding tissues. Surrounding tissues and cause granulation. This surrounding tissue can be bones of jaw, face, etc. So what is malignant otitis externa? In some cases of otitis externa, the infection can spread to the surrounding tissues of bone, like the bones of jaw and face, etc., and cause granulation. This thing is called as malignant otitis externa, or another name is necrotizing otitis externa. So the causative agents for malignant otitis externa. First is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. This is the most common causative agent for malignant otitis externa. Others are Staph aureus, Staphylococcus epidermidis, Actinomyces and Aspergillus. These are the causative agent for malignant otitis externa. The people who are at risk for malignant otitis externa are elderly, diabetic patients, patient with the immunocompromised state, patient taking radiotherapy or chemical therapy, and HIV patients. Now we'll discuss how does the infection spreads. Suppose this is a external ear canal, external ear. If the infection is spreading medially, it will affect middle ear or petrous bone. If it is spreading anteriorly, it will affect temporomandibular fossa and joints and parotid glands. If it is affecting posteriorly, suppose the infection is spreading posteriorly, So it will affect mastoid bone, cranial nerve number 9, number 7, that is facial nerve. Other cranial nerves which may be affected are 9, 10, 11th and 12th. So the infection, if it is spreading medially, it will affect the medial ear or petrous bone. If it is going anteriorly, so it will affect the temporomandibular fossa and joint. And if, along with it, it may affect parotid gland too. If it is going posteriorly, it will affect mastoid bone and the cranial nerve number 7, which may cause facial paralysis. And other cranial nerves which may be affected are cranial nerve number 9, 10, 11 and 12. Now we will discuss the symptoms of malignant otitis externa. We may see foul smell, we may feel foul smell from the external ear. We may see yellowish or greenish, discharge from the ear, which is most commonly due to the causative agent, that is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. The patient may feel excruciating pain. We may also see hearing loss, and most important, granulomation of tissue. We may also see swelling, redness, itching, in the external ear. Other symptoms which we can see are fever, facial paralysis, we may see weakness in facial muscles. We may see voice loss and also laryngitis. These symptoms are seen very rarely, but these are the main symptoms which we observe in any patient of malignant otitis externa. The diagnosis of malignant otitis externa. Diagnosis is usually done using gallium citrate 67 scan, which is most helpful for diagnosing or monitoring the malignant otitis externa. Then we may do CT scan or MRI. This is just to check whether we have any intracranial complications or not. This is just to check intracranial complications. We may also do biopsy in order to rule out the cancer. We should do culture and sensitivity test. So diagnosis is done using gallium 67 scan, which is most important in diagnosing the malignant otitis externa. We may do CT scan or MRI in order to check whether we have any intracranial complications. Then we'll do biopsy just to rule out the cancer, and we'll do the culture and sensitivity test for finding the causative agent. So now, after everything, we'll discuss about the treatment of malignant otitis externa. Malignant otitis externa is usually caused due to Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So if we are giving any antibiotic therapy, so we'll just try to focus that the antibiotic should have effect on Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So we'll prescribe the patient anti-pseudomonal penicillins. Or any third generation cephalosporin like ceftriaxone, cefzidime, etc. We give either of them with a combination of any aminoglycosides, for example gentamicin. But it used to have a side effect. Aminoglycosides itself have a side effect of nephrotoxicity and ototoxicity. So now we have replaced this doctors usually replace this aminoglycosides with quinolones. Quinolones like ciprofloxacin or ofloxacin. Along with it, we should try to control the diabetes of patient. Control diabetes mellitus. We should clean the external ear by doing toilet of ear canal. If earlier we used to do a surgery which we used to call as extensive surgical debridement, but now it is very rarely used because it has been replaced by the antibiotics in recent times. We will discuss some questions related to malignant otitis externa. So the first question is malignant otitis externa is, the options are malignancy of external ear, Pseudomonas infection in diabetics. The third option is blackish mass of Haemophilus or fungal infection of external ear. So when you are in an exam hall, you are in a very great pressure. So the most common mistake is done in this question by reading the term malignant. People usually mark the answer as a malignancy of external ear, but in the beginning of the lecture, in the beginning of the video, we discussed that no, the malignancy term used here is just a misnomer, that is, it is given a false designation that it is a malignancy of external ear. So this answer should be not marked as correct one. Blackish mask of hemophilus, we don't see any blackish mask, we see just a yellowish or greenish discharge from the external ear, so this answer is also not correct. Fungal infection of external ear, yes, it is a kind of infection due to which otitis externa occur, but no, it is not a fungal infection, it is a bacterial infection, so fungal infection is also wrong answer. It is Pseudomonas infection in diabetic patient. We have discussed that diabetic patient are at a higher risk for the malignant otitis externa. So the correct answer is malignant otitis externa, Pseudomonas infection of in diabetic patient. So now the next question. Which of the following are not a typical feature of malignant otitis externa? I repeat the word, I repeat the question. Which of the following are not a typical feature of malignant otitis externa? The first option is, it is caused by Pseudomonas . Second option is mitotic figures are high in number. Third option is patients are usually old, and the last option is patient is immunocompromised. So once again, I'll repeat the question. Which of the following is not a typical feature of malignant otitis externa? It is, the options are caused by Pseudomonas, yes, so it is not the answer, because we need to find which is not a typical feature of malignant otitis externa. Second option, patients are usually old, yes, it is seen in elderly patients, so no, it is not an option. Mitotic figures are high in number, we don't know exactly what is mitotic figures are. And the fourth question is, patient is immunocompromised. Fourth option is, the patient is immunocompromised. Yes, malignant otitis externa is seen in immunocompromised patients. So it is also not the answer. So by the technique of excluding the wrong answer, we come to a conclusion that mitotic figures are high in number is the correct answer. So what are the mitotic figures? Mitotic figures are nothing but something which we see in malignant neoplasms. So now the next question. Question number 3. All of the following are true. All is true about necrotizing otitis externa except. So the first option is, it is caused by, all is true about necrotizing otitis externa except, it is caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Second option, surgery is never done. Third option, it is seen in diabetic patients. And the last option is facial nerve is affected. So the question is, all is true about necrotizing otitis externa except first option, it is caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Yes, it is true. Second option is surgery is never done. This is also true, kind of true. It is seen in diabetic patient, it is also true. And facial nerve is affected, it is also true. All the four options are correct. Now we'll need to exclude a one option by which we should get at least an answer. So it is caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Yes, it is true. So we'll not mark it as an answer because we need to tell which is not true about necrotizing otitis externa. We'll go from down now. Facial nerve is affected. Yes, it is affected. So it is also not a correct option for this question. It is seen in diabetic patient. Yes, it is seen in diabetic, HIV, immunocompromised and elderly patients. Now the fourth option which we have is surgery is never done. Surgery is done, but we very rarely do surgery in this case. So we'll mark surgery is never done as an option, as other options are 100% correct. Yes, it is caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It is seen in diabetic patient. Yes, it is 100% correct. Facial nerve is affected. Yes, it is also 100% correct. But we can take this option as 50-50. So we'll go for this option. Surgery is never done. All is true about necrotizing otitis externa except caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Surgery is never done. It is seen in diabetic patient. Facial nerve is affected. So we'll go with the option surgery is never done. We can get such tricky questions in exam, so we should be clear with our concepts. So the next question. True about malignant otitis externa is first option, it is not painful. Second option, it is seen in diabetic patients. Third option, caused by staph aureus. And the last option is all are true. Question is, true about malignant otitis externa is, it is not painful, it is seen in diabetic patients, it is caused by staph aureus, and all are true. We feel pain in malignant otitis externa. Which kind of pain? Excruciating pain. So this is not the correct answer. If one answer is not correct, so all of the above is also not the answer. So we have two options, seen in diabetic patients and caused by staph aureus. Yes, it is seen in diabetic patients, so it is a 100% correct statement. But it is also caused by staph aureus. But the most common cause of malignant otitis externa is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So we'll go with the option seen in diabetic patient. We'll take one more question, that is most common cause of malignant otitis externa is. I know everyone will mark the correct answer as I finish with the option. The first is staph aureus. The second is influenza virus. Third is Aspergillus niger. And the last option is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. So we all know, we have discussed it many times. So the answer is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. We'll have a short review once again about malignant otitis externa. What is malignant otitis externa? It is a kind of otitis externa caused by Pseudomonas aeruginosa. It is most commonly seen in diabetic patient, HIV patient, immunocompromised patient. For the diagnosis, we usually go for gallium citrate 67 scan, which gives us 100% correct result. We may also go for CT scan and MRI, which will help in understanding the intracranial, if the patient is having any kind of intracranial complications. For treatment, we go for the we should control diabetes. We should clear the ear canal. We should we should go for the antibiotic therapy, which has now replaced the surgery. The antibiotic therapy includes the drugs which are effective against Pseudomonas aeruginosa, as it is the most common cause of malignant otitis externa. In this, we will give anti-Pseudomonas penicillin, anti-pseudomonal penicillin, or we will give third generation cephalosporin, both IV intravenously. Along with it, we give we used to give aminoglycosides, but now we have replaced it by quinolones, that is ciprofloxacin or ofloxacin. Thank you. That was about all about malignant otitis externa. Hope you like the video. Please like, share and subscribe our channel MediSimplified. Thank you.